Good afternoon and welcome to BBC Sports coverage of the Women's Super League today. Birmingham against Everton coming up here on the BBC Sport website and app in WSL 1, the only game in the top tier this afternoon. The other games played on Friday night and Saturday. Here, both teams looking for their first points of the season after losing their opening games last week. Birmingham, an agonising 3-2 defeat against Arsenal. Everton, a fairly comfortable defeat against their Merseyside rivals Liverpool 2-0 at home back in Widnes in the Select Security Stadium. Here in Birmingham, up against Everton for the first time in a couple of years. Everton back in WSL 1 after they were relegated and then their licence approved to return back into the top tier of the women's game. And alongside me for commentary this afternoon, England international Sue Smith. And Sue, we've seen a lot of goals already during this the opening games of this WSL. Not sure how many we'll see this afternoon, but I don't want to put a jinx on it.
I was just going to say, you just jinxed it already before we've even started. But yeah, it's been the start to the WSL has been fantastic and lots of goals, which is what fans want to see. It's what we want to see as commentators. I think it'll be probably a little bit more of a defensive display from both of the teams today. But looking at both sides, they've both got goal scorers in their team. Ellen White, absolutely prolific in the first game. And exactly the same with Everton. Courtney Sweetnam-Kirk, she's moved up from WSL 2 into WSL 1, proven goal scorer at that level. So can she now make that step up? So they have got goals in their team. So hopefully, even though you've just jinxed it, we might get a few goals.
But as we said, both sides beaten on the opening day in kind of fairly different circumstances. But it'll be interesting to see how they approach this. Very early stages, they'll want to at least get a point on the board, won't they?
Yeah, and it's who can, I suppose, show the most character, because it must have been agonising for Birmingham, the fact that they conceded so late on in the game against Arsenal with a penalty. They'll have thought and believed when they were on the pitch that they'd won the game, and the fact that when you get beat, it's so difficult as a player, as a coach, you've got to try and pick yourself up and look at this game. But I'm sure they will, because that's something that Mark Skinner does. He's very much a motivational type coach. He'll be in there with his team, working with them for the last week or so, getting them ready and prepared for this game. I think Everton probably will know that they were beaten by a better team on the day against Liverpool, but for a large part of the game they did match them, so I think they can take positives from that. But yeah, they'll want at least a point, because you want to get a point on the board as early as possible, because I think the longer that goes on, the more difficult it becomes.
Well, we've seen that in the men's game, haven't we? Crystal Palace and the season, of course, a lot shorter in the women's game, so obviously you don't want to go too long without getting the goals and the points. Everton yet to score, but they did have chances, didn't they, against Liverpool?
They did, and again, I think that's the step up from WSL 2, that you probably get one or two chances at level one, and you have to put them away, you have to be clinical, and at WSL 2 you probably get more of those chances. So that's a learning curve for Everton, and I think something again that they will take into this game. I'm sure they'll have practiced shooting, and they'll know that if they do get a chance, they have to make it count.
So here come the teams then. Birmingham in their home strip, the royal blue shirts, white shorts and blue socks, and Everton in their change strip in the grey. And changes for both sides as they attempt to get their first points on the board. We'll go through the teams in just a moment as the fair play handshakes are taking place. And Birmingham, known for their defensive solidity, but conceded three against Arsenal despite the Gunners going down to 10. And Everton looking for their first points and first goals as well. So here are the teams then for Birmingham. Four changes for them. I must say three changes for Birmingham, the side that lost to Liverpool on the opening day. Sorry, Birmingham lost to Arsenal on the opening day. Four out, Harrop, Ewers, Ebby Lee Stringer and Emma Follis come out of the side. In come Emily Westwood. Hayley Ladd makes her debut after signing in the over the close season from Bristol. Charlie Wellings and Lucy Quinn also come in to the side, with Ellen White, who got two goals in that opening day against Arsenal, up front leading the line. Stenson Ayisi, Harrop, Ewers and Cusack on the bench. Also a change in system there for Birmingham, reverting back to a back four. For Everton, three changes for them to the side that lost 2-0 to Liverpool. Siri Vorm, Claudia Walker and Molly Green drop to the bench. In come Faye Bryson, 20-year-old academy product. Simone McGill is up front alongside Sweetman Kirk. And Chloe Kelly, on loan from Arsenal, makes her first start for the club. So as we can see, the Winter League up and running. Dreary day in Birmingham. Gonna have to get used to that. And Ellen White on such top form for club and country in the last few months. Great to see after a couple of pretty serious injuries. And there's Andy Spence on the left, the Everton boss. Been at the club for so long. Had a little spell out when they were relegated. Back in now. And hoping to guide Everton to some success in WSL 1, their first season back in the top tier after they're relegated to WSL 2 in 2014. Incidentally, that's the last season that these two sides met. It was a miserable season for Everton, but they managed to get a point in both their games against Birmingham with 0-0 draws, but they didn't manage to win any of them. And we understand there's a slight delay to kick off here. Problem with the goal nets, perhaps not expecting the inclement weather at Birmingham. So we might kick off a couple of minutes late. So changes for both sides, Sue. It's obviously going to be a long season. They're going to need to rotate the squad, but quite an early stage to do this, but perhaps understandable after defeats for both.
Yeah, and I think a change of system as well for both teams, which is quite interesting. And I think that's, again, something that you have to do when you're playing at the highest level, be able to change systems and players to be able to adapt to that. So whether you're playing four at the back, whether you're playing three at the back, players know how to play in that particular role that they have to play. And yet changing personnel. And I think it is a long season. And I think now teams have squads and good squads so that the players that come in are just as good as the players that go out. So it enables them to have a rest. I'm not sure players would probably want a rest after one game, but I know I certainly wouldn't want that. However, I think it's it's good that both teams have changed and adapted their style.
So here we go then, a slight delay to kick off, but we'll be underway imminently at Birmingham, the home of Solihull Moors, the non-league side. There's the Everton goalkeeper, Lizzie Durack, made a couple of stunning saves against Liverpool, but was on the end of a 2-0 defeat.
That's got to be the worst thing as a player when you've just gone out onto pitch, you've just done your warm-up, you're ready, you're all prepared to go, and then there's a real hold-up and you've got to get the footballs out and start passing the ball around. Mentally, you've got to try and stay switched on.
Yes, there does seem to be an issue with the goal nets here, which you'd think they would have tried to sort out before. But hopefully it will be fixed and we'll be ready to go very shortly.
Must have been all them powerful shots in the warm-up.
Ah, there you go. Always looking on the bright side.
Yeah.
Some of the results from yesterday in WSL 1. The big one, Manchester City winning 5-2 against Arsenal. Bristol with a huge 1-0 win against Yeovil. That could be massive come the end of the season in terms of the relegation battle. And Chelsea winning 6-0 at Sunderland. Five different goal scorers. Back-to-back 6-0 wins for Chelsea to start the season. and they look like the team to beat.
Yeah, they really do. And I think already it's shown the two top teams, the Chelsea and Manchester City, the fact that they are scoring goals from all over the pitch.
Hallelujah, we are underway. Birmingham against Everton, with Birmingham kicking us off. They are in the blue, kicking from left to right. And already on the attack here with Ellen White. Williams swing the cross in. White can't take it under a spell. Hegerberg takes a swing, but it's nodded away. Everton clear towards Sweetman Kirk. Former teammate of yours, Sue, as you mentioned in the build-up, making that step up to WSL 1. It's a big season for her, isn't it?
A really big season, and it's something that she's always wanted to do. She said that the reason that she's gone to Everton is the fact that she wants international recognition, so she has to be playing well for Everton to start with. But yeah, proven goal scorer at WSL 2. She works so hard, and the fact that she's come back from a pretty serious ankle injury just shows what type of person and character she actually is.
20 goals in 18 games as Doncaster were promoted a couple of seasons ago. Absolutely prolific, and then suffered that terrible injury. But back on track in the spring series. See how she can do as she makes the step up. Birmingham on the attack. And they win the throw off Munsterman. One of two Belgian internationals that have joined Everton in the off-season. The other one, Vorm, on the bench. Wellings, Williams, shot charged down. Here is Hegerberg, who provided the two assists for the two goals for Ellen White against Arsenal, ultimately in vain.
She's just got a little bit of quality in there, always looking to get onto the ball.
Here is Sweetman Kirk, putting the Bone defence under pressure, and the back pass just got to the goalkeeper there.
That's exactly what Courtney Sweetnam Kirk will do. She'll make defenders' life an absolute misery. She'll chase everything down. And if there is a mistake, she'll be the first one there to capitalise on it.
Didn't look too convincing from Birmingham, but they got away with that one. It's Danielle Turner, the new Everton skipper, just 26 years old, but the joint oldest member of the Everton squad. And that in itself is a challenge for Andy Spence.
It just makes you feel so old, doesn't it? But yeah, she's a great character, and I think she'll help lead the team. And I suppose Andy Spence will be looking for the future if he can keep these players together and build something. There's a lot of young England internationals there as well. He's definitely got a team full of potential.
Jodie Brett, signed from Chelsea. Bryson for the run of McGill. Mannion's there to clear up. Not a great clearance by Berger. Here's Munsterman. Good pressure by Everton this. Turner. Really well to get the ball back, Daniel Turner. Sweetman Kirk couldn't quite keep that one in. Chloe Kelly, forward on loan from Arsenal. Is Andy Spence, really part of the furniture at Everton. Also won WSL Coach of the Year at the Women's Awards. a few weeks ago after guiding his team to the Spring Series title in WSL 2. Here's Ellen White. Everton look to build something here. Cross comes in. Wellings was there, put behind by Bryson.
That was good build-up play from Birmingham, and that's exactly what Hegerberg does. She gets on the ball in between those little spaces, looks for Ellen White, who has that quality. And I think if Birmingham can get the ball out wide and get crosses into the box, that's where they'll be really dangerous.
Opportunity here for Birmingham from the set piece. Hayley Ladd comes forward to take the corner kick. It's a decent delivery. White's there. It was a free header, good movement by White, but couldn't keep the header down. I think she might feel she could have done a little better with that opportunity.
Definitely, I think she'll be probably disappointed because her movement was excellent initially to get away from her marker. And then it was a free header. She just couldn't get over the ball enough to head it on target. But that's a chance, and especially with Ellen White's ability in the air.
Questions will be asked about the Everton defence, leaving Birmingham's most potent striker unmarked. Mannion, the England under-23's captain, and Sargent just took her eye off the ball. Given away. Wellings, now Ladd. Quinn's made the run here. Got George for company. Quinn gets the cross slash shot and nearly catches out the goalkeeper, Durack. She's been very effective down that right hand side already, Lucy Quinn.
Yeah, she's looking to get in behind, and you can see that Birmingham are looking for that crossfield pass. You know she's got pace. I think with Everton playing a three at the back, they'll see that's where the space is, that's where they can exploit.
Williams this time, with the deep corner. Just evades the run of Sargent. Williams, one of the signings made ahead of the Spring Series, after spending a couple of years in Italy. Birmingham boss Mark Skinner guided his team to the FA Cup final, of course, last season, but didn't have a great Spring Series, just the one win all season. Still very much a work in progress, Birmingham. Been real fixtures in the top tier, but you never quite know what you're going to get with them.
No, and I think that's something that he's addressed. He wants that consistency, and he wants his team to be challenging the best teams. Showed that against Arsenal the opening day, that he could have actually gone and got the win, and that would have been an upset. But like you say, you never really know what Birmingham you're going to see. But he's a top coach, and the players seem to really respond to him and to his coaching methods. You can see they're trying to play football.
Sargent goes long. That breaks down. I think the majority of teams, at least in WSL 1, do try and play football, get it down and play it. Remember last week with Bristol City against Chelsea, it was sometimes to their detriment, but they stuck to it. The manager absolutely insistent they keep playing it out from the back, and occasionally, because they were playing Chelsea, they were punished. But they stuck to their philosophy, and it was admirable.
Yeah, and I think that the more now that the teams are training every day, that they can work on those patterns of play, they can work on playing the ball out from the back and the movement from the midfielders, and you can see it's getting better and better. So I suppose the more that they do try it, but sometimes as a fan you probably just think, just get rid of it, don't try and play out from there, especially if you keep getting caught.
Right on cue, George clears her lines. Very effective defender, Gabby George, has been at Everton for a good few years now after coming through the Manchester United Centre of Excellence. Spence back in the dugout. He left for 6 months in 2015 to become the club's technical director at the Centre of Excellence, but couldn't keep away. Back with the first team. So successful last season. Won 7 out of 9 of their games. Best defence. Best attack in the league.
And I think sometimes when you get into that winning mentality, you then take that forward, and it was exactly what Sunderland did when they got promoted. So they'll have a real belief, a lot of the players coming into this, but you just don't want them to go too long without getting a point on the board.
Mannion, the run forward, stopped by Finnegan. Here's Munsterman. Sweetman Kirk had made the run, and that was a vital header by Westwood. Westwood took a chance, came out the right side of that Sweetman Kirk challenge.
Got to say, really good pressure from Everton there, and you can see that's what Andy Spence has told them to do. He knows Birmingham are going to try and play the ball out the back, and he's got his team really working and pressing together as twos and threes.
Good pressure by Wellings. George forced to put it out for a throw. White wins the corner kick. Intelligent play from the England striker. Again, Paige Williams with the left foot. Delivers to the near post, and Durack had to get that right. Re-signed for Everton over the summer after 4 years away at Harvard University. It's another good delivery. Durack punches it straight into the path of Ellen White. Her third goal already of the new season. And Birmingham ahead. Excellent delivery. And Ellen White, well, she was not going to miss from there.
No, that's a striker's goal for you, isn't it? Absolute poacher. Good delivery from Paige Williams. She's just decided she's going to put the ball exactly on the goalkeeper, on Lizzie Durack. And I've got to say, it's poor goalkeeping, poor defending from Everton. But who's the first one to react? It's Ellen White. And she'll be disappointed she missed that opening header. But she certainly make amends there.
Durack, well, she'll perhaps feel she could have dealt with it better, but it was right on her, wasn't it? It was more about the delivery, I think we should praise for that one.
Yeah, I think so, but I think she'll be disappointed because I think she's got to do something with it, either collect it or punch it. I'm not a goalkeeper specialist, but I'm sure that's something that a goalkeeper coach will say. Just get rid however you can.
Everton look for the immediate response, but what a header that is from White. Finds her teammate Quinn, who can't take it under her spell. But from an Everton perspective, that's a real hammer blow. It's an early goal to concede, and one that was pretty messy once again.
That's the things you've got to get right, set pieces, both attacking and defending in, at this level. Because when you've got somebody of Paige Williams' ability, her left foot, she can whip a ball in. And then obviously Ellen White is in goal scoring form at the moment.
Mark Skinner, he'll be very pleased with the start his side has made. I'm sure he'll be more concerned now about the other end of the pitch after conceding three against Arsenal. And that looked tight. Simone McGill had made the run. Good ball, good movement, just offside. Westwood under pressure. Picked up by Munsterman. Good technique. Here's Hayley Ladd, Welsh international, making her debut for Birmingham. That is an excellent pass to Carter. Great strength. I think Carter was pulled back there. She keeps going. Here comes the cross, and White again was first to it. And very close to getting hers, and Birmingham second. Excellent play from Carter.
I've got to say, I love the honesty from Carter as well, because there was a definite pullback, but she kept going because she knew she got the ball. Just a real powerful run, direct, get the ball into a dangerous area, and at any touch that could have gone in.
Big fan of Jess Carter.
Yeah, me too.
She could pretty much do anything, can't she?
She can play central defence, she can play fullback, wing back, or as a holding midfielder, which she's probably doing a little bit more of today. She just doesn't seem fazed by anything, does she?
Absolutely. She won the 2016 Young Player of the Year, and it's almost a surprise how young she is, because she just feels like she's been around for so long, made her debut at 16, and still so much time. And I think there's only a matter of time before we see her in an England shirt. Still just 19 years old. Birmingham have their tails up here. So important that Everton just get back into the game, isn't it? In the next couple of minutes.
Definitely. They need to remember the game plan. There's Andy Spence writing his notes and then seeing what they need to do next. Because sometimes you start a game with a particular way of playing and a style of playing, and then things go wrong, you concede a goal, and you tend to change that way, and you need to just stick to it, because that's obviously the way your managers, your coaches set you up. If you want anything to change, you can get a message onto the field. And they were doing okay up until that point. It was just a mistake. And they've shown glimpses, haven't they, Everton? Simone McGill nearly getting in. Courtney Sweetland-Kirk nearly getting in. I think if they can play off the back shoulder of the Birmingham defenders, they've both got pace to get in behind, as long as they find the right ball through.
Jodie Brett wins the free kick. Wind's really getting up. Turner tries to get past Quinn. Oh, now Ellen White closed down the goalkeeper, Durack. She dwelt on that a little bit. White, though, oozing with confidence, you can see. Loving every minute of being out on that football field.
I think Durack just took an extra touch, but I don't think her defenders helped her out there. There was no angle for her to to play the ball out, which she was looking for initially.
Hegerberg. Just to find White. Quinn battling for it, loses out. Picked up by Sargent. Now Hegerberg. Good feet. Given away. Hegerberg may have taken a knock. She was surrounded there. They're all having a swing at her, trying to get the ball off her. Jess Carter receiving some instructions from Mark Skinner. I hope Hegerberg can continue. Such a creative player.
Yeah, you can see good feet. She's got two, three Everton defenders around her. Hopefully that's just a knock rather than any sort of twist. It's always awful to see when it's a knee. But hopefully it's more of a bruise than anything else. Because, yeah, she's that creative player in the middle of the park that will set up the likes of Ellen White. And if Wellings pushes on, good on the ball.
Hope that Charlie Wellings can understand what Mark Skinner's telling her to do. Semaphore. Norwegian international, of course, but it's her younger sister who steals the headlines. Leon striker. They surprisingly didn't do well at all at the Euros. Didn't get out the group, didn't pick up a point. It was a big shock, that.
It was, and considering she is such a good player, you want players like that to be shining on the big stage. But no, it didn't happen for her or her team. Must be tough, that, mustn't it, if your younger sister's better than you. That must be such a hard one to cope with. I'm sure they're quite competitive, aren't they?
Oh, I can imagine. You're kind of already competitive with your siblings, but when you play the same sport, and must be interesting at Christmas time. Birmingham are in here. Carter. She wants a foul. She looks absolutely incredulous. She was through. She went down, and the referee has given nothing.
It's a really difficult one to see there. I think it looked like she was just falling.
Oh, what a ball that is. Ellen White is offside, though. Birmingham looking very good going forward. There was a little arm on Carter, but perhaps not quite enough. Ellen White just offside.
Again, a really direct run from Carter. That's what she can do from midfield. She's got that pace, that burst of pace to get past the defenders. She's causing them problems, running from deep.
Everton's struggling to get hold of it, and Birmingham win the free kick. The only game of WSL 1 today, but you can see highlights from all the top tier games. The women's football show tonight at 11:30 on BBC One. Special guest Jordan Nobbs. Hegerberg takes aim. Good save by Durack. She's already shown her shot-stopping abilities in the opening game against Liverpool. Acrobatics from Durack, and what a strike that was from Hegerberg.
Fantastic from Hegerberg. She just seen she had space in front of her, no defender closing her down. That's what I would say if I was the goalkeeper. You've got to close her down. She's got the ability to do that. But what a save from Durack. And that's exactly what she did in the Liverpool game. Her shot stopping is excellent. I think she's showing that she's as good as her younger sister now, isn't she? She must have heard us.
Quinn, that was a took a chance there. Sweetman Kirk tries to get a second bite of the cherry. Good strength, and she wins the free kick. Sweetman Kirk. And Everton take it quickly. Here's Turner towards the back post. Sweetman Kirk can't keep that in. Do you know, that was a really good opportunity to have a shot at goal, that free kick. They opted to take that quickly. I think she's not sure if that was the right decision from Everton.
No, I think they could see that Birmingham's defensive shape was not quite there, so they went to play the ball out wide. Dan Turner just overhit the cross. But yeah, could they have set up? Had a go at goal.
By McGill. Kelly pushed off it by Williams. And making some territory here. Bryson. George looking for options. Captain Turner. McGill will pick this one up. She's got Turner for company. She finds her, Turner. An awkward one for Westwood. In the end, it comes to nothing, but that's the sort of thing that Everton need to do more of, isn't it?
Yeah, just better build-up play. Dan Turner getting on the ball and playing the ball to McGill. And it's going to take a bit of time, I think, for Everton. They have got a lot of new players, a lot of young players, and it will take time for them to gel. You can see it's nearly there. Sometimes that just takes a few games.
Good play by White. Dispossessed though by Brett. White's frustrated. She didn't see any movement up ahead of her. Bryson. Sweetman Kirk asking a lot of her. I think from Everton point of view, they will hope to get something from this, although it's looking unlikely at the moment with the pattern of play, because next up they're away at Chelsea. Ouch. 12 goals scored, none conceded. Good challenge by Williams on Kelly. It's a poor pass by Wellings to White, but she's got it back. White goes for goal, in confident mood, but always rising.
I think you mentioned it earlier, it just looks like Ellen White is loving her football at the moment. It looks like, you know, Mark Skinner's give her, not really a free role, but allowed her to go and get on the ball, make things happen more centrally, forward, that's where she wants to play. She's creating goals, she's scoring goals. And it's all with a smile on her face.
it's tricky for her, isn't it, with England, because there's so many attacking options and they almost try to, you want to play them all, but it's so difficult, isn't it? Here's Turner with the cross, away by Mannion, picked up by Quinn.
And it seems to be whenever she gets the opportunity for England, she performs. So it must be, or it must have been a difficult job for Mark Sampson to decide who he was going to play. I suppose it depends on the team as well.
That's a great ball over the top. White, a little bit isolated at the moment. Waiting for options. Good challenge by George. Not happy with the fellow defenders. Another opportunity from the corner kick, and they scored from their last one, Birmingham, from this exact position.
I think if you were Paige Williams, you'd put it exactly on the goalkeeper again, wouldn't you?
Caused all sorts of problems the last time. I think we can guess where this one is going. Here is Williams, goes deeper this time, nodded away. Lads there. Here's Mannion. Williams. Oh, what a ball and a touch from White. Squares it. And it's another for Birmingham. Charlie Wellings. Brilliantly recycled by Birmingham. Unselfish play by Ellen White. And Charlie Wellings, she just had to pick her spots, and Everton in real trouble now. Birmingham 2, Everton 0.
That's a great team goal from Birmingham. Initially, the corner didn't quite go where they wanted it to go, but Paige Williams, what a ball. Great movement from Ellen White. And that's the unselfish play of Ellen White. Good first touch. She looks up, sees that Charlie Wellings is in better position than she is. Great ball through to her. And a cool, calm finish from Wellings. Good team goal.
A penny for his thoughts now. It's going to be really hard for them to get back into this. They have the capability, they have the quality, but they just look a little bit rattled, Everton.
They do, and I think that's what Birmingham do to a lot of teams. Physically, they dominate teams. And when they go forward, they do go forward with pace.
And could it get worse? Carter sees that out for a corner kick. And all the last one, the last goal wasn't scored directly from a corner. It was the second ball that came in. Everton need to get this one away properly this time. Ladd with the delivery. Another great whipped ball in. White was there. The set piece delivery has been outstanding, hasn't it, from Birmingham so far?
Both sides. Paige Williams with her left foot and Hayley Ladd with her right foot. All that needed was a touch. It had so much whip on it.
Kirk tries to get the move going for Everton. Here's Bryson. It's a poor touch by Munsterman. She's absolutely clattered, lads, and I just wonder if there might be further punishment here from the referee. Signs of frustration in that challenge.
Yeah, I think she realised it was a big touch out of her feet. I think the referee's just having a word rather than giving her a card. I think she's quite lucky, if I'm honest. It's just a real late tackle, but again, it is frustration. Can't excuse it though.
And again, Sweetman Kirk charging down the goalkeeper, Berger, and Sweetman Kirk has been penalised for a foul. Don't think there was any malice in that. Every right to go for it, but just caught Berger a little bit late.
Yeah, I think the ball was definitely be, it was there to be won. And that's what she'll do. She'll close down defenders. She'll close down. You can see it's quite a big touch out of her feet. I think that's slightly harsh.
Courtney Sweetman-Kirk gets the yellow card.
I think she saw that Berger had took that big touch and it was an opportunity for her to try and get something from it. It's the last thing that Birmingham will want to see, though. Berger injured because she's such an excellent keeper.
Well, additionally, they've sent their other keeper, Sophie Bagley, out on loan to Bristol City, and the goalkeeper they have on the bench today is 16-year-old Fran Stenson. So if Berger can't get up from this, there she is, Stenson. She is an England international, a youngster. She's been named in the under-17 squad, but certainly inexperienced is putting it lightly. Born in April 2001. Doesn't that make you sick to your stomach?
Oh, it really does. But again, it's an opportunity for her if she does come on and show what ability she's got. And I think sometimes when you're young as well, you don't have any fear. You just want to play and you don't really care that it's a big game to come into. But I'm sure that the Birmingham players, that the last thing that they'll want to see is her down injured. Because she is just an excellent keeper, and I think she breeds confidence to the defenders because she's so commanding and vocal, and she'll come for crosses. Yeah, I think she's very highly rated there.
Seeing this again, and I think Sweetman Kirk, well, she did catch her, but I think the yellow card was slightly over the top from the referee. She, as you say, she had every right to go for that, really, didn't she?
I think if you were Courtney Sweetnam Kirk's manager and she didn't go for it, you probably would say, you'd ask the question, why not? But I suppose it was the whole debate with the Mane in the men's game.
Well, and yesterday, you'll see that on the women's football show this evening. Nikita Paris got away with a very high foot, and if I'm correct me if I'm wrong, I don't think she got even a yellow card, and she nearly took Lisa Evans's eye out. So I'm sure that'll be a debate that will be had this evening. Be a very topical at the moment in men's and women's football. Looks like Berger should be okay to continue. Stenson sits back down. Her opportunity, I'm sure, will come at some point.
A bit of heart rate raised by a few beats there, thinking that she was going to come on.
Berger will just try and walk this off and see how she feels. It's a poor clearance from Durak, seized upon by Hegerberg. Carter goes for the shot. Excellent effort, and not far away at all.
Really good pressure from Birmingham and Charlie Wellens especially. And what Birmingham are doing really well is they're picking that second ball up. So they might not win the first press, but the second one, they're always the first to it. That's what Everton just need to be better at.
Hegerberg just held on to Munsterman a bit too long. By Ladd. Carter cleared only towards Quinn. He might take a shot here. It's Clucy Quinn, charged down by George. Of Quinn, one of three signings in the off season for Birmingham from Yeovil.
Everton are getting a little bit overrun in the middle of the park. Whether you need your wide players to come in and make it a little bit tighter, or either McGill or Sweetman Kirk to just drop in, just to try and get a hold on the game. So Birmingham aren't only just dominating it physically, but they're the first, they're the second to every ball.
Do you think a change of system would do that?
Maybe that's something that Andy Spence, he might have been writing that on his pad when we seen it.
Because they started with four at the back against Liverpool, they've switched to a three, which I believe they used for the spring series, which was so successful in WSL 2. Guess he's still trying to figure out the right formula for the step up.
That's the thing. And again, against different teams, and I have been impressed with how Birmingham have played in the middle of the park.
This is promising for Everton, but once again, the final pass not quite there. McGill and Sweetman Kirk both in the mix. Loose touch by Carter, picked up by Kelly. Again, Birmingham just first to it and easily intercepting these passes. Ladd is clattered by Munsterman, who is already on a warning. Not sure if the referee will be quite as lenient this time, or maybe he will. He's calling Daniel Turner, the captain, over to have a word.
I think he's saying, you are on your last warning. You've done one over there, you've just done another one. They're just clumsy, but she's lucky not to have a yellow card.
Good call and a good take by Jurak. There might be a slight bone of contention with Mark Skinner. I think if you were an opposition manager, you might feel that Munsterman should have been in the referee's notebook. And Finnegan this time with the challenge. Fouls are racking up in this game, and another opportunity from the set piece for Everton, been so successful with them thus far, and with 3 minutes plus stoppages to go until half time, Everton really don't want to concede another. Another great cross floated in, White was there, difficult opportunity for her, but typically she went for it.
Oh yeah, she'll go for anything that's around the box, that's what she'll do. And this isn't a bad delivery, she's just aiming for the back post, just too far for Ellen to get any sort of contact. But maybe that's showing Everton's a little bit inexperienced, the fact that they keep giving away needless free kicks, needless corners. When you know a team are very good at set pieces, they've got good delivery, don't give them away.
Wanted the foul from George. She gets it this time, Ellen White. Oh, she's very angry at Gabby George. Wonder if something was said. The referee's given the foul. Felt that George was a little bit too physical with her, but he will have a word with the defender as well.
Do you know, I'm not sure if there's a little kick afterwards. I'd like to see it again. Because I think as Ellen White fell, and Ellen White doesn't react like that unless something has happened, like you say, whether something was said. I wasn't sure if there's a little kick. We can see here, so wins the header well, and as Ellen White's falling, just a little tap, you know, it was nothing, but again, would just wind you up as a centre forward, and you can't do stuff like that. If that gets spotted.
Oh, Carter goes over. Everton treading a fine line here. The ball comes back in. Ellen White. Just straight offside once again. That was a good save by Durack, but Everton look pretty panicky when the ball comes into their box, and that was a possible claim for a spot kick again.
They can't cope with Ellen White's movement. They can't cope with the quality delivery into the box. And something that I've been impressed with Andy Spence is that he has very good organisation. He organises his defence really well, but here they don't seem to have been able to cope with Birmingham's movement.
3 minutes of time added on. Wellings looks a little bit in pain. But that little tap going back to the foul from Gabby George, that's very, very risky, because even though it wasn't a huge amount in it, if that's spotted,
that's it, you're off. And you think it, the linesman's on this side as well. So if he sees that and tells the referee, it's just silly again, it's just inexperience.
You see George has been, she's kind of a frustrated figure, hasn't she, this half. She's been remonstrating with her teammates as well, and finally this time Munsterman does get the yellow card.
And George is a top defender, loads of potential going forward, really good 1v1, strong, uses her body well. But yeah, you can't do things like that.
Carter wants the handball, and it's given. Perhaps a final opportunity for Birmingham to increase their lead for the half-time break. Williams with the delivery. Ball defenders in the first instance from Bryson. Here's Carter. Now Quinn goes for it with her left foot. And easily held by Durack. Keeping Kirsty Lavelle out of the team. Played every single minute of the spring series. Slightly more experienced, Durack. Nearly turns into trouble. Good feet by Aoife Mannion. Risky play, she got away with it.
So you can tell I'm a forward, I love stuff like that. Great feet.
It depends where you do it.
Yeah, I'd be a rubbish coach.
Cruyff turns on the 6-yard.
Yeah. As long as it looks good.
And you were in the running for England manager, according to some betting websites.
Yeah, don't put any money on that.
There goes the half-time whistle. Fairly comfortable in the end, so far anyway, from Birmingham. Ellen White with the first, and then assisted the second for Charlie Wellings. Sue Smith, work for Everton to do in that second half.
Yeah, definitely. A lot of work for Andy Spence, I think, to talk to his players, to motivate them for the second half, because I think it was a dominant display from Birmingham. I think they defended really well, and I think when they went forward, they looked dangerous every time they did. So I think good performance from Birmingham City. Everton need to step it up.
We'll see what sort of response, if any, from Everton in the second half. But half-time, Birmingham 2, Everton 0.
Birmingham City, ladies, we'd like to give a special thanks to official club partners Maple Products of Quebec, Solihull College and Snapstack. And all the great sponsors here today, a warm welcome to all of our partners. Thank you for your continued support of the club. Enjoying your afternoon with us. Here's those for today.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Solihull Moors, Birmingham City against Everton in WSL 1. Birmingham leading Everton by 2-0. But we have a surprise substitution coming up here. Anne Katrin Berger, she took a knock in the first half, the goalkeeper. So there's going to be a first senior appearance for the 16-year-old Fran Stenson. Now, if you were Everton, Sue Smith, you might feel like this is an opportunity here.
I think the first thing that you would say is shoot. I think you'd say test her at every opportunity, despite she's got a very good record at a younger level, younger age groups. And again, I know they speak very highly of her. I'm sure she's been aided with Berger when she's training with such an experienced goalkeeper. I'm sure she's progressed and developed, but of course she's a young goalkeeper, you have to test her. But a real opportunity for her, and I just hope that Ann-Katrin Berger's okay, and I hope it's just a precaution, that it's nothing too major, because you don't want to see her injured, because she is such a top quality goalkeeper and part of Birmingham's defence.
And a substitution for Everton as well. Claudia Walker coming on to the field. And Georgia Broom coming off. So perhaps a little tactical switch there from Everton. That's a forward player for a defender. Of course, they are 2 down. So if they are going to attempt to get something from this game, that is what they're going to have to do. But be interesting to see how they line up now.
Yeah, you'd probably think a change of system there, because you would expect Walker to go straight up top. Maybe McGill drop in as a number 10 position. They go to a flat back four.
If you missed it in the first half, Fran Stenson, the goalkeeper for Birmingham, was born in 2001. Just drink that in a little bit. As if we didn't feel old enough already. Here is Carter. Goals in the first half from Ellen White, her third already of the season. And she laid on the second for Charlie Wellings. There is confirmation. Berger, she was just caught late by Courtney Sweetman-Kirk. She carried on, but clearly not feeling too comfortable. It's an opportunity for Everton to get back into it straight away. And Kelly has a goal on her full debut within a minute of the restart here. And what a terrible way for Stenson to make her senior debut.
What an excellent start there from Everton. That's exactly what Andy Spence will have said. He'll have said, go out there, make sure that you get the first goal. Really well anticipated from Chloe Kelly. Courtney Sweetman-Kirk with the initial pass that was deflected round, but that's a good quality finish.
And Everton are right back in this. It took a bit of a lucky deflection, didn't it, from Courtney Sweetman-Kirk's ball, and Stenson didn't do too much wrong. She came out. Good finish by Kelly. But that'll do absolutely nothing for her confidence, will it?
No, not at all. Again, what you will have wanted, you'll have wanted to just get a touch on the ball early on. You don't want to be picking the ball out the back of the net.
It's confirmation of the other substitution. Munsterman, who was on a booking, off for Claudia Walker. Game on though, because Birmingham, well, they could have had more than two in that first half. Everton looked completely overrun, and now they're already back in it. Got a feel for her.
That'll just give Everton so much confidence. You know, they've got four attacking players on the pitch now. Courtney Sweetman-Kirk just dropped to the left-hand side. Looks like Chloe Kelly's on the right, and then you've got your two centre forwards as well.
Carter wins the challenge. She's fouled by Kelly. Paige Williams. Hegerberg lays it off for White. Carter. Welling's well shepherded. George loses out. Turner eventually clears. Just snapping into the challenges a little bit more, Everton, already.
Again, I think that's probably something that he said. You have to be a little bit more aggressive when you're playing teams that are physical. You've got to put the challenge in and not just win the first ball, but win the second ball, because that's what Birmingham did so well in the first half. They were picking every loose ball up.
They'll do their defending, though, as well. Here is Ladd. Good run. Plays in Quinn. Another good cross towards Ellen White. And Brew puts it out.
Birmingham do look so dangerous when they get the ball out wide and they get good delivery into the box.
This has been Everton's Achilles heel in this game anyway. Here is Williams once again. Finnegan deals with it. It's over the top by Emily Westwood.
Again, it's a good delivery into the box. This time Everton did have players around Westwood. I know she won the header, but they made it difficult for her. But that's the thing, Everton probably will be focusing on Ellen White, making sure that she doesn't get on the end of it. But they've also, Birmingham have got other threats from set pieces, Emily Westwood being one of them. You know, Mannion's good in the air, Jess Carter.
Carter manages to poke the ball through to Hegerberg. Now here's Quinn. To White. Again, neat build-up play from Birmingham. Hegerberg. Here is Carter. Another corner kick. Carter was in there, cleared only up towards Hegerberg. Shot comes in, and an easy take for Jurak. The second half couldn't have started much better for his side. Already a goal back, but need to build on it now. Here's Brett. Kelly had come short. Cleared by Williams.
Just think if Everton can get that final ball, which I think was lacking slightly in the first half. The weight of pass or the wrong pass, if they could get that right, I think they'll cause Birmingham more problems. So they certainly have the players that can finish Everton.
Sweetman Kirk loses out to Ladd. Willings behind Carter, but she has time to pick it up. Everton preparing their second substitution. Not before this free kick though from Birmingham. Again, Paige Williams. She looks so deadly with her left foot.
Around that one, Paige Williams. Too close to Durack.
Carter penalised. Former Manchester City defender. Part of that back three that conceded so few goals in the spring series. McGill. Tried to play in Sweetman Kirk, it was well charged down. Walker doing all the closing down on her own.
She made Birmingham make a mistake.
Comes the substitution for Everton, Finnegan off, and Olivia Chance will come on, a New Zealand international. She signed ahead of the spring series, scored three, makes her first appearance of the new season. Again, that might mean a bit of a reshuffle by Everton. We'll just have to wait and see. Chance more of a midfield player. Chance. Wins the free kick. Referee's pulled it back. Hayley Ladd not impressed by that decision.
I think it was the right decision.
Reduce the arrears. Turner with the free kick. Straight at Stenson. Good anticipation. Here is Walker. Tried to pull it back for Turner. Good play by Kelly. Pulled back by Hegerberg. Much better from Everton this second half.
I was just going to say that whatever Andy Spence has said to them at half-time, they look a completely different team. They look quicker to the ball, they look sharper, they look more aggressive in the tackle and better going forward. Maybe that's just a little bit of belief that they needed. That's such an early goal.
And Kelly's free kick is disappointing. And the pass back is even worse. And Walsh should be punished. Here's Charlie Wellings. Cavalry are coming. Ellen White making a run into the box. Hegerberg wants it. She's got it. Everton back in numbers. Hegerberg's shot charged down.
That was poor from Kelly. Initially to give the ball away, but then a reaction. She didn't track back. She just threw her arms in the air. And I know that's something Andy Spence, I'm sure, will pick up on. And you can't do that at this level. You have to try and get yourself back in, whether you make a mistake or not. You don't have time to dwell on it.
Still lots of time, of course, for Chloe Kelly to learn. 19 years old, on loan from Arsenal. Came here, I'm sure, because you get much more game time as a forward. Basically impossible to get into the Arsenal squad.
Yeah.
George is being closed out by Wellings. Wins the free kick, the throw-in, I should say, off Quinn. White with the flick on. Good play by Turner. Great strength. And in the melee, Quinn is penalised. Lovely play by Chloe Kelly. Brilliant feet. Couldn't quite thread the ball through to McGill. Poor challenge by Turner.
It's a great play initially from Kelly. And I think that's what you want from your wide player. You want them to get on the ball and beat defenders. She's got a turn of pace to be able to do that. And then it's just about maybe finding that final pass.
Lovely play by Everton, Claudia Walker. She's made an impact since coming on, and Sweetman Kirk forces Carter to put the ball out of play. Flowing football from Everton now.
She's got a point to prove, hasn't she? Claudia Walker left out the starting 11. She wants to show Andy Spence that she should be in there, and I think she's done really well in this second half.
Certainly made an impact from the bench. The second top scorer in the WSL 2 Spring Series, 7-9. They also have the top scorer in their ranks, Everton. That was Courtney Sweetman Kirk with 9. Here comes the corner kick. Brilliant header. Here's Bryson. Sweetman Kirk. Walker. Well held by Stenson. Promising signs from Everton.
Really is. Much better in this second half. Just the passing's better. They look more dangerous when they go forward.
Yeah. He'll know, though, that this is the opportunity they need. It's a cliche, isn't it? But when you're leading 2-0 and then concede one, get a little bit nervy.
Yeah. They say that, and it is a real, it's a horrible scoreline when you're leading 2-1. You want that third goal to just give you that cushion. And even though you probably say as a player it doesn't affect you and it doesn't play on your mind, it does.
George clattered Hegerberg. It's another silly free kick to give away. Here it comes. Ellen White was there again, though. The offside flag goes up.
Just done that on too many occasions, Everton. Just give away needless free kicks.
Everton will make their final substitution. Chloe Kelly, the goal scorer, makes way for Chantal Boy-Lorca. First appearance in a long time, missed the spring series and missed most of the 2016 season with an ACL injury, so a big moment for her to come back. And can she make an impact from the bench? It's another forward player, though.
Yeah, it's great to see her back. Just for personal terms, the fact that she has been out with a, like you say, an ACL injury, such a horrible injury to come back from. She's worked her way back. I know she's worked really hard on the training field. And she was another player before that. So much was talk about her potential. Hopefully she can make an impact in this, not just this game, but this season. She deserves that.
Well, Everton, they've shown all their cards now. All the substitutions are made, all of them attacking players. So let's see what they can do. Walker, great turn and a good ball to Courtney Sweetman-Kirk. Sweetman-Kirk is in here! Straight at the goalkeeper, who held it well. Stenson, the angle was narrowing all the time. Decent opportunity, though, for Everton.
Lovely switch of play initially to Courtney Sweetman-Kirk, and then what a first touch. Just took her away from the defender. Just couldn't quite get any power on the finish.
Well, you said walk out a point to prove. She's been absolutely brilliant since she's come on.
She's defending from the front. She wants to get on the ball, wants to make things happen.
Pass from Mannion, but Westwood gets onto it. Upfield by Sargent. George finds Sweetman-Kirk, dropped deep. Bryson, now Walker. Lovely play. Sweetman-Kirk, though, can't keep possession.
The only thing Everton need to be cautious of is that quick counter-attack from Birmingham. They've had a lot of possession, a lot of the ball, playing really well, but Birmingham are a threat when they go forward.
You can see, though, Everton building in confidence here. Sweetman-Kirk, it's again a pass cut out. Williams. Good header on by Chantal Boy-Lorca, and Walker had made the run in behind. Good anticipation from Stenson.
Stenson's done well, considering she's come into this game. Her team are under the cosh. She's had to make a few saves, come out, collect the ball. Doesn't really seem fazed by anything.
And as you say, that's the positive of being so young.
Yeah.
Much more of an even contest now, though. There's Ladd. Bristol City. Bryson does well. White back to Williams. It's another good delivery. And Williams is penalised for offside. Quite a few of them on the Birmingham team.
It's a great, great first touch. Just in a path on her right foot. That's where she needed to go, across the goalkeeper, but just needed more power.
I think credit to Williams as well, because she just pushed her out a little bit wider than perhaps she'd like.
Maybe more of a difficult angle for her to shoot. Certainly seen Courtney score them from there.
Comes in from Bryson. Oh, it's dropped by Stenson, picked up by Boyd Lorca. She gets it back from Turner. Here's Brett. Sweetman Kirk. It's a good ball, and again Stenson. It's absolutely battered by McGill. In the end, her team get away with it. I think perhaps the referee could have blown up for a foul. This is poor play by Birmingham. They're giving it away again. Here's Boy Lorca. Goes for goal. Too far away.
Uncertainty there from Stenson.
Well, we'll have to wait and see, but Charlie Wellings potentially has scored the winning goal here. She's got the Birmingham second. And an interesting sub, because Abby Lee Stringer comes on. So that's a forward off and a midfielder on. Just wonder if that's a little bit... Well, we'll see where she goes, but maybe a little bit negative from Birmingham.
Yeah, it's quite conservative, and I think the reason for that is because Everton are completely dominating this second half. And I think they need something else in the middle of the park to try and get on the ball. And Birmingham have been sloppy in the second half with their passing. First half, really impressed with them. And again, that's probably credit to Everton that have stopped Birmingham from playing. They've just upped the intensity.
Allowed to stride forward. Here's Walker. She's been the pick of the impact subs. Here's Chance. There's McGill's ball to Boyd Lorca. They didn't come off, but they've won it back with Turner. It's Boyd Lorca. Dinked ball in. Westwood was there. Mannion. Difficult header. It's out for another corner kick. And I think Everton should take a leaf out of Birmingham's book and try and put this right on the keeper. Gone for the shorts, Everton. Here's Boyd Lorca. Not bad delivery. Lost away by Sargent. Walker was there.
But
very involved already, Chantelle Boy-Lorca. She gets the cross away. Sweetman Kirk tried to get on the end of it. And Boy-Lorca right on the roof of the net. Just tried to get something on it in that instance.
She's another player that's come on, wants to make an impact, wants to prove a point. And that's, I thought Everton were lacking people that wanted to get on the ball, wanted to make things happen in that first half. But since the substitutions have improved dramatically.
Wonder from a Birmingham perspective, you know, they squandered a lead twice last week. Do you think that'll be playing on their minds a little bit?
Yeah, I do think so. And again, I'm sure Mark Skinner's been working on that game management, because that's so important in football, the fact that they let the lead slip so late on in the game. And he'll probably be a little bit concerned. He'll want that third goal, just that cushion, but they don't look like they're going to score that third goal in this second half. It's been all Everton.
Lovely play by Everton. Boy-Lorca, pass to Claudia Walker, doesn't quite come off. Challenged by Carter. Shows her strength. There's only going to be one winner in that challenge. In the nose from Hegerberg. Carter gives it away. And good pressing from Everton, trying to force the mistake from Birmingham. And that's a mistake from Turner, though. Here comes Quinn. Hegerberg was there. What a challenge that was by chance, just to intercept the pass. Carter with the cross. Broom away. Mannion pulls down Walker.
I've been really impressed with Walker. I know we keep mentioning her, but just the attitude. Some players sulk when they're left out and they come on and they don't really perform. She's completely gone the opposite way and thought, right, I'm going to come on and I'm going to show exactly what I can do. And she's changed the game for me, for Everton.
Again, as we mentioned, the Everton squad, so young. Another one who's barely out of her teens.
Oh, stop it.
Just 21 years old. It just shows that what's great, though, is when they show this sort of skill and intensity, that they have a lot of years to get better as well.
Definitely, and together. So they'll work as a group and develop as a group. And because a lot of them do play international football as well, they've got that.
Abby Lee Stringer just getting a talking to.
Late.
That could have been dangerous had the Everton player not jumped out of the way.
Yeah.
Good strength by Ladd. Stringer. Carter's got a bit of room to pick the cross. Might deflect kindly for Hegerberg. White wanted it slid through to her.
That would have been the better option.
Keep possession. Chance gets the ball out to Borjulorka. Good feet, his chance again. Really could go either way at this point, couldn't it? Sargent felt she was clipped, but just the throw-in given by the referee. Talked about Birmingham's mentality after last week twice conceding the lead and getting nothing out of the game against Arsenal. Well, that's playing on their mind. For Andy Spence, after all the good work in the second half, if it does finish like this, he might feel like it's an opportunity missed.
Yeah, I think so. And managers always say, oh, we've got to take the positives out of the game. And there's a lot of positives that Everton can take from this second half, the way that they've shown how they can pass the ball around, they can work together as a team, they can create chances. But yeah, I think there's definitely a point to be taken here, and he'll know that.
And the fact that the game, if it does finish like this, was lost in that first half where they were just overrun. And if they'd played like this for the full game, then it would have been a lot more, well, it would have been easier for them.
Definitely. And some mistakes in the first half. They looked a little bit nervy. Maybe it is that inexperience at this level. Maybe give Birmingham a little bit too much respect. But this second half, they have showed that they can perform at this level. They did against Liverpool for large periods of the game. But it's such fine margins when you step up a level.
And performing for the full game, isn't it?
Yep. And if you're not performing, you're maybe the team that's under the cosh slightly, you don't concede.
We saw yesterday, Chelsea, they were held by Sunderland for quite a long time, but then the floodgates opened, 6-0 in the end. We obviously highlighted that tonight on the Women's Football Show. 11:35 BBC One with Ailey Barber and special guest Jordan Nobbs. I'm sure she'll have some reflections on that defeat for her side, Arsenal, against Manchester City. Time running out here for Everton. Sweetman Kirk trying to ghost pass Ladd.
I've been impressed with Ladd. Real versatile player. She's got that international experience through playing for Wales. But I think she's come into the side and she's slotted right in. She's protected the defence when she's needed to, but she's wanted to get on the ball, wanted to make things happen.
Yeah, one of three signings, Hayley Ladd, for Birmingham. They did most of their business ahead of the spring series. Seven new signings for Everton. That's another factor that might come into play. They might just get a little bit more cohesive as the games go on. One-touch play by Birmingham. Sargent with some space to run into. Moves it forward towards Quinn. That's a play by George. Birmingham going to start taking their time over these throw-ins and set pieces, etc.
That's where they need to look at the experienced players to do things like that. Keep the ball, pass the ball around, make Everton work. All ways to try and get the clock down. You can tell I've used some of those, can't you? Run it into the corner.
Speaking from experience. Reprogramming the referee's watch.
Yeah. Tried them all.
White, scythe down by Bryson. She's enjoying it even when she's fouled.
But again, she knows that that just... You know, it's a silly foul. Doesn't need to do it. She's got a back to goal. And this is another opportunity for Birmingham in a dangerous position.
But that was the point you were just making. It's kind of experience of Ellen White, who just slowed down her run. She knew she was going to be clattered, and the inexperience of Bryson, just 20 years old. She'll learn those tricks as she she gets older. Ladd will take this free kick. For Birmingham. Williams is unmarked, floated in. Now perhaps Everton can get something on the break here. Claudia Walker, McGill, that is a brilliant pass. Simone McGill in behind the defence. McGill couldn't get the power on the shot. Brilliant counter by Everton. Birmingham sliced apart. But the finish lacking from McGill.
Yeah, there was just no conviction in that shot. But what a quick counter-attack from Everton. I thought they were in there. It was a lovely ball through to actually see the pass and then good way to pass. But it was just that first touch took her too far wide. Couldn't get any power on the shot. Similar to Courtney Sweetnam-Kirk earlier on.
Yeah, pretty much carbon copy, wasn't it? Big opportunity and they've conceded another free kick. Hegerberg's taken a bit of a clattering today, hasn't she?
She really has.
And Bruin, the latest player to go into the referee's notebook, the third player in a Everton shirt.
Just a quick feat of Hegerberg. Draws in the defender. She's always going to win her team fouls.
I don't think Birmingham will leave themselves as open as they did from their last free kick. That was kamikaze, wasn't
yeah.
it? He's not been quite as comfortable as he did in the first half. There's another trick for you, just spending some time doing the laces up. Here's Ladd. Just over the head of Sargent. Led off for Sweetman Kirk, it didn't come off. Here's Hegerberg. Brum. Anywhere will do at the moment for Birmingham. By George. Referee pulls it back. Four minutes of added time. Four minutes for Everton to try and win their first point of the WSL 1 season. They don't have it where they want it at the moment. Good play by Carter. That drop out of play for a throw-in. Applauds the linesman. He looks very pleased. Where they want it, don't they? Birmingham right in the corner flag in the opposition half. Textbook.
Yeah, they'll be quite happy with this.
Great play by Claudia Walker. Walter McGill cut out though. Walker still going. Stenson had to get that one away, and she did. A mix-up. George gets away with it. Good anticipation by Brum. Out by Carter. Throw into Everton. As well to put the defender under pressure. Stringer, White. And another free kick to Birmingham. More seconds ticking away. Luck trying to get it off Jess Carter down there.
I was just going to say, give it to your strongest player in the corner. She didn't agree with the linesman on that occasion.
No. The friendship request is rescinded. It's a good kick by Jurak. George with the header. Andy Spence urging his team forward. George charges down the clearance. Opportunity here, Sweetman Kirk! What a block that was by Williams. And the follow-up, Bryson, well over the bar. Sweetman Kirk, she thought she was going to get the equaliser there. Williams, what defensive work from her.
Yeah, I don't want to take anything away from Paige Williams' block because that was absolutely fantastic. Last-ditch defending. I think Courtney Sweetman-Kirk could have done that a little bit quicker. She took a little bit too much time again. WSL 2, you can probably get away with that. You have to take that quick snapshot when you get the opportunity. Fantastic defending, though.
Birmingham survive. Relief for him and agony for Andy Spence, the Birmingham boss. Terrific game in WSL 1. In the end, the two goals from Ellen White and Charlie Wellings have won it. Kelly pulled it back so early on in that second half. Everton pushed and pushed, but Birmingham hold on for the win. A first win of the season for them, their first points. Everton still looking for their first points of the season. Sue Smith.
I've got to say, I feel a little bit sorry for Everton. I think second half, they got themselves back into the game, and I thought maybe a point each would have been the fair result. Birmingham dominated the first half. I thought Everton had the better of the second half. They had three good opportunities in the second half that they didn't take, and that's the difference. You have to be clinical. Positive for Birmingham is the fact they were able to hang on, and I think that's something that Mark Skinner will be happy with. He's got the 3 points on the board now, and despite not being the best team in the second half, they've still managed to get the result that they wanted.
A tight game, edged by Birmingham, who get their first points on the board. Everton still yet to get off the mark. Full time, Birmingham 2, Everton 1.